Welcome back. We are at the Blue Line Sports Bar and Grills. Football Weekly continuing.
Coming back in 2019, I knew you were pretty confident before COVID hit that the Johnnies would be on a great track that season. So how do you, I mean, now you're under the radar, you know, with this team. Describe what you see as the potential for this group. There's no Tommies on the schedule to measure up against and that type of thing. So it's two divisions of the MIAC. It's a lot of differences from the last time the Johnnies took the field.
Yeah, I think one of the best things that will happen for us this year is playing Aurora right off the bat. I feel like teams have kind of flown under the radar now for a little bit after having the target on our back. But I don't think that has, you know, harmed us at all. I think that's actually given us some confidence. We kind of come together as a group of guys that, you know, off of such a good team that, you know, teams think you're going to pull back. Well, at St. John's, we don't talk about rebuilding. We talk about reloading. We got a whole bunch of guys, you know, a bunch of young guys that were, you know, freshmen or sophomores on that 2019 team that have been working their butt off in the weight room and then on the field to get better. And now it's their time to shine. You know, we got a whole bunch of guys, like we said, that haven't played football for a year and a half. It's going to be fun. It's going to be exciting. And guys got to step up and get their chance. It happens every year at St. John's that key guys show themselves in the first couple games. And then we become one of the best teams in the country. I think we got guys that we know can do it. And now it's going to show when we get the chance.
Stepping up, he's gonna get hit, he's gonna get sacked.
Oh, what a run by Devin Bolt.
Looking for a hole, back to find. Nothing but outer blue there for St. John's. Jimmy Buck with a 6-pointer for the Johnny.
Third and 10 for the Johnny 40. Johnny's rushing extra man, big sack by Michael Washington. And receiver's gonna throw it, by Austin, touchdown. Right into Paul Yu, who says, hello me, and slams into the turf back at the 30-yard line.
When you so lit that you can't tell the love real. If I can't tell you nothing, I tell you how tough feel. And you ain't see your stash and pay my drug bill.
Hundreds on hundreds on hundreds on hundreds. My homie and I, but he know I rock, so you know that already. However he coming. We done went up on these like 79. They talking about bodies, we talking about men, we talking about money, they talking about killer. I gotta go to the bathroom as soon as I walk in the
man. Jimmy Fox with a 6-pointer in the end zone. Yeah, he's at the 5, and he's into the end zone again. Power play to the left works, and it's 13-0 St. John. 15, 10, 5, Henry Gross in the end zone for the third time this afternoon. He's at the 5, and he'll walk into the end zone. Touchdown, St. John. Go up the 1. Severson play fake, keeps the ball, throws in the end zone. Standing there is Larson.
With Larson inside the 5, stretches out. He's in. Touchdown, Johnny.
And Detro, scoot body left to the 5, and he's into the end zone. Pass under pressure, gets hit by Moore, and pulled to the ground.
You know what we have to do today, right?
Sure.
We got to play our best game of the year. We got to be gritty and nasty today. Play after play. Okay? Championship teams, this is where they show their mettle right here. This is where they show how good they are. Let's take the next step today and win this game.
Inside the 5 to the 2. He stumbles forward, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Johnny.
Knocked down. Nice job by Wozniak. A Weisberger, and he slams him down back at the 40, 19.
35-30 at the foot race, and Croce is going to win it. He rumbles 48 yards for the score.
He gets sandwiched and dropped.
The left sideline for Robbie. He adjusts, and he makes the catch, and he's got it at the 1.
From right in inside the 5 to the 2, he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Kevin Bolt from 9 yards out.
One tackle to the 5 to the 2, spins, and he's going to be in the end zone. Touchdown, St. John.
Henry Croce. Johnnies went 38-10 at Laird Stadium. They're now 9-0 and will be at Bethel next weekend for the MIAC Championship game.
The sack leader in the MIAC, Seth Morham, takes him down. Sack number 8 for Morham on it. Backus is hit at the 2, stretches out, touchdown. Inside the 20, to the 15, running to daylight, and he gets the snap. It's low. He's looking, slap pattern, knocked down. Knocked down by St. John. The pocket going over the middle for Buck. Makes the catch. He stiff arms a man.
dodges the man at the 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10, touchdown
from 13 yards out for Robbie Olsen. Under pressure from Wozniak, and he goes down back inside. It's open a crease, and both goes 50 yards for St. John's up. And off, and then in the backfield is Bonds, and Michael Wozniak with a mic drop. He's under pressure, he gets dropped by Wozniak. Another mic drop for Michael Wozniak. His seventh sack of the game. Makes the catches in the end zone, touchdown.
Give to Brown, and Brown's getting met by Paul Yu in the back.
He was kneeled down, that's it. Johnny's with it, 41-14.
Brown's going to get hit, he's going to get stacked. Right away, met Elias, Paul Yu.
Baker gets hit,
and he's stacked again, back at the 45-yard line. A mic drop from Michael Wozniak. Pressure. He's going to get sacked again in the first sack of the year. He's got Colin Brandt at the 25-20, 15-10-5. Touchdown, Johnnies. They're back in it. Rolling right toward the back of the end zone. Austin has it. Is he in? Touchdown, St. John's. Wow, one play right works for St.
Let it fly.
He's got Patrick open. Makes the catch to the 15-10-5. Touchdown, Johnnies.
It's been a fun ride. Came back, obviously my fifth year. Wanted the opportunity to be around the guys one more time. It's just been fun to be a part of the team. Every role I've played, third string, backup, holder, you know, playing in this game, it's just been a blessing to be here at St. John's.
It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. A regular crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me. To his tonic and gin.
We eat on the field, and we eat on camera.
You guys set yourselves apart in this one thing alone. You had to beat a team twice to win an MIAC championship. That has never, ever been done before.
Yeah.
I mean, that alone for your senior class, for this program, that speaks volumes because of the fact, and you had to go on the road to do it. That's the other thing. You know, quite frankly, that's a pretty good accomplishment.
Yeah. Well, you think about it, like, what a privilege it is to play for a program like St. John's. You know, again, not the ending that we wanted for the season, and we didn't really get to the goal that we achieved, but there were so many great memories and highlights along the way, and, you know, it's pretty cool to be a part of a program where you have all those successes and the expectations are there and you're meeting them. So, yeah, and like you said, being a good Bethel team twice, like, it's not easy to do.
My antennas,
baby! Up top, pork chop, my antennas, baby!
Think of the Chris Backuses, the Colin Franz, Seth Morris, Nick Newman's, all those guys that could have left, Tyler Johnson, and those guys all came back, and they were the leaders of this football team. I've coached a lot of teams. It's my 40th year, and I've had some incredible memories, but I'm not so sure I'll ever have a better memory of a team than what we did this year, just because of what those guys had to go through to come back, and then the manner in which they did it with great leadership and incredible fortitude. Can't say enough about them. Push it to the limit, I can't go no more. Red light, no way, I'm coming back home. Long dirt road all on my own. I'ma be the greatest, write my name in the stone. Write my name in the stone. Yeah, I'm coming back home. Yeah, I'm coming back home. Write my name in the stone. Cause I'm coming back home. You know, there has never been an MIAC team that has been in the playoffs 7 straight years. You know, we kind of made that as one of our expectations for the year. We wanted to get back for a 7th straight year, and that's not easy to do. I mean, you got to be on your toes every week, and in our situation, we're going to get the best out of everybody every week. You know, having the kind of year they did, and they have guys step up, we didn't miss a beat. You know, I know we're disappointed. All we can do is get ready and make another run at it next year. Push it to the limit, I can't go no more. Red light, no way, I'm coming back home. Long dirt road all on my own. I'ma be the greatest, write my name in the stone. Write my name in the stone.